Hello children, how are you doing? Hope all of you are safe. I am your English teacher Sujata. Let us have a recap of part 1 of the lesson, The Pickwick Club. As you know, Mr. Samuel Pickwick was an old man. He had a generous heart and he always wore glasses. He lived in England and everybody was interested in science. And he himself was interested in science and natural history. After that, all his friends thought that he was very intelligent. Then all his friends and he made a club called the Pickwick Club, and he was the important person in that club. Then one day the club decided that Mr. Pickwick should go on special journeys, and he has to write notes about everyone he met, everything he saw and whatever happened in front of his eyes. Then he has to post that note to the club so that all the members should read and have some scientific interest in that. Then 3 members also accompanied Mr. Pickwick on his journey. Those 3 were Mr. Tracy Tupman, Mr. Nathaniel Winkle, Mr. Augustus Snodgrass. All the expenses, means the money, should be paid by Mr. Pickwick. And the next day the journey was going to start. And have a recap of the 3 people who have followed the club. Then here, first, Mr. Tracy Tupman was a middle-aged man. He used to respect beautiful women. But as time passed, his handsome structure changed into a fat body. Then Nathaniel Winkle was a young man. He used to love sports. And last, Augustus Snodgrass was a young man. His parents died when he was very young. And he used to write poetry. Then the morning of 13th May 1827, the journey started. And Mr. Pickwick opened a wide window of his bedroom and saw down in the Goswell Street. And whatever he saw was only buildings of the Goswell Street. Now, let us continue with the lesson in part 2. Scientists, thought Mr. Pickwick, should not just look at things closest to them. They should look deeper and discover the truth hidden beyond. Mr. Pickwick had thought his first scientific thought of the day. He then got dressed and put some clothes into his travelling bag. 10 minutes later, he caught a cab to the coachyard at Golden Cross. That was where he had arranged to meet the other 3. Then he thought that, as I have a scientific interest, I am a scientist. All other people used to think he is very intelligent. So he thought that whatever I see, I should look in deeper into that and discover the truth. Then Mr. Pickwick got dressed. He packed his travelling bag and 10 minutes later, he took a cab, means a taxi, to the coachyard where all the carts were there at Golden Cross. Then that is where they have arranged other 3 also should come there. Mr. Pickwick also should go there and meet them. On the way, there he walked to the cab driver. How old is that horse, my friend? Mr. Pickwick asked. 42, the man replied. What? Said Mr. Pickwick in surprise. Some horses live to be 20. A few reach 30. But Mr. Pickwick had never heard of a horse that was over 40 years old before. He quickly pulled his notebook from his pocket. Then, after that, when he took a cab, he has started talking with the cab driver. In the last slide, you have seen the picture. There was a cab driven by a horse. So even this Pickwick also took one like that. And then he started talking with the driver who was driving the cab. He asked, what is the age of the horse? Then the cab driver said, 42 years old. Then Mr. Pickwick was surprised. He knew that horses live up to only 20 years. Then some may reach up to 30. But he had never heard of a horse that is over 50 years old. 40 years old, sorry. Then he took his notebook to write about the horse. How long do you keep him working each trip? 2 or 3 weeks, said the cab driver. Weeks? Repeated the astonished Mr. Pickwick. Yes, said the cab driver. We hardly ever take him home because of his weakness. His weakness. Then the next question that was asked by Mr. Pickwick is, how long do you keep him working? Means, how much time it will the horse work. Then he said that 2 or 3 weeks. Then surprised, astonished means surprised. Then surprised Mr. Pickwick asked, weeks? Then cab driver said, yes, because he has some weakness, so we always make him work. He asked, what is his weakness? He always falls down when we take the cab, but when he is in it, we tie him very tight so that he can't fall down. And as we have two nice big wheels on the cab, when he does not move, the wheels run after him and push him forward. He must go on. He can't help it. Mr. Pickwick was astonished, but he thought it was very interesting too. He carefully wrote down every word in his notebook. Then the cab driver told the secret behind keeping the horse working for more time. He told that whenever we untie him from the cab, the horse will fall down. So we always keep him tied to the cab so that he cannot fall down. Then one more thing was, the cab has 2 big wheels. Even if the horse doesn't move, the wheels used to push him up. Then without any hurrying or without any nice work, the horse used to move forward with the help of those wheels. Mr. Pickwick was again surprised, but he thought that it is very interesting. So he started noting down all the things in the notebook. The tall, thin young man. Just as Mr. Pickwick finished writing his notes, the cab driver arrived at the Golden Cross Coachyard. The cabman jumped down. Mr. Pickwick got out. Mr. Pickwick's 3 friends who were waiting for him there came to greet him. Then after that, when he finished his note writing, the cab arrived at the Golden Cross. Then the cabman also jumped down. Mr. Pickwick also got out. As it was already told to other 3 people to be there, and they were waiting for him there, and they came to him and started greeting him. Mr. Pickwick paid the cabman. The cabman threw the money down onto the ground. Mr. Pickwick was surprised. The cabman said he wanted to fight him. Then, as it was decided, Mr. Pickwick paid the cabman. But he threw the money down on the ground and stated that he wanted to fight with Mr. Pickwick. Listening to this, Mr. Pickwick was surprised. Are you mad? Mr. Shortglass said to the cabman. Or drunk? Said Mr. Winkle. Or both? Said Mr. Tracy Tupman. All the 3 people also were standing there with Mr. Pickwick. And they started to tell something to the cabman. First one told, are you mad? Second one told, are you drunk? And the third one told, are you mad and drunk? Both. Come on then, said the cabman, waving his fist about and beginning to dance around them. Come on then, I'll fight all 4 of you at once. Then the cabman, as you can see in the boxing ring, how the people will move when are about to fight. Even here also, the cabman started to dance around the 4 people and said that, I'll fight with 4 of you at once. 6 or 7 other cabmen crowded around to see what was happening. They had smiles on their faces. They thought they were going to see some fun. Then, as you know, if anybody is fighting on the roads, the crowd will gather around. Here also, the crowd started gathering. All the other cabmen started coming around and standing together as a crowd. Then they had smiles on their faces as they thought that they are going to have some fun there. What's the trouble? One of them asked. Spice, said the cabman. The old one asked me a lot of questions. He wrote down everything I said. Then he tried to get these others to start a fight with me. But I'll teach them a lesson, I will. Then the cabman told that these are the spies of other country. They are here to know our secrets and all. Then he said that the old man in the group was asking a lot of questions. And when I told answers, he was noting them down. And he called others also to start a fight with me. But even though they are 4, I'll teach them a lesson. The angry cabman attacked. First, he knocked down Mr. Pickwick's glasses off. Then he hit Mr. Pickwick on the nose and again on the chest. He then hit Mr. Snodgrass in the eye and Mr. Tupman in the waistcoat. After that, he danced out onto the road. Then he danced back onto the path and threw himself at Mr. Winkle, knocking all the breath out of his body. Then the cabman started attacking the four people. First, as you know that Mr. Pickwick always wore glasses. First he knocked on the glasses off, then hit on the nose, then on the chest. Then Mr. Snodgrass in the eye and Mr. Tupman in the waistcoat. After that, he went in onto the road, again came back to the footpath and he started hitting Mr. Winkle. "You will be sorry you did this," said Mr. Pickwick, lying on the ground, his face red with anger. Then Mr. Pickwick said that you will be sorry because you are fighting with us. When he was saying that, his face was red with anger. Just then a tall, thin young man arrived. When these four people along with the cab driver were fighting, a tall, thin young man came there. "What's all the fun then?" asked the young man. "Police spies," shouted the crowd. Then he asked the crowd who was gathered near the people who were fighting, "What is this all going on here?" Then he said, the crowd said that these are police spies. "We are not," shouted Mr. Pickwick just as loudly. Then when the people said that these are spies, Mr. Pickwick told that "we are not spies" very loudly. "Well, I believe you," the young man called out to Mr. Pickwick. He pushed his way through the crowd. "Now, cabman," he said, "stop all this nonsense. Take your money. I know this gentleman well." The tall, thin young man who came there told the cabman that, "I know Mr. Pickwick very well. He is a gentleman. Stop fighting with them. Take your money and go away from here and stop all this nonsense of fighting on the road." Mr. Pickwick was surprised yet again. He had never seen the tall, thin young man before. The young stranger then took Mr. Pickwick by the arm and helped him to his feet. He led Mr. Pickwick and the others to the waiting room. He ordered some brandy and hot water for them all to drink. He then asked the waiter to bring something to put on Mr. Snodgrass' red and swollen eye. Then Mr. Pickwick was very surprised when the young man told that, "I know Mr. Pickwick very well." He was very surprised because he had never seen that man before. The stranger helped Mr. Pickwick to get up by taking his arm into his, and then he was standing on his feet. Then all of them, the three people, Mr. Pickwick and the young man, went to the waiting room. In bus stations or railway stations, you will have waiting rooms. There, if the train is late, you can wait. Then he ordered some hot water and something to drink for everyone. Then the waiter brought these all things and he told to bring some ice or something to put on the eye of Mr. Snodgrass because the driver bet him on the eye. The drinks came. The stranger drank his very quickly. Mr. Pickwick was very thankful. He began to talk to the stranger and ask him some questions. Before the stranger could answer, someone shouted out at the coach of Rochester was about to leave. "Rochester," said the stranger. "Oh, Rochester, my coach, I must go. Sorry, I have to ask you to pay for the drinks." And he ran out of the room. Then the drinks came and all started drinking. But the stranger, the thin young man, drank his drinks very quickly. Because he helped Mr. Pickwick and his friends, Mr. Pickwick was very thankful to the stranger. And as you know that, decided by the club that whomever Mr. Pickwick meets, he has to ask some questions and write down the notes. He started asking questions to the stranger also. Then, before the stranger could answer the questions of Mr. Pickwick, someone in the courtyard started. The coach for Rochester was about to leave. Means one of the coach which was going to Rochester City was about to leave. Then stranger said that, "Rochester, oh Rochester, my coach, I must go." That young man was going to Rochester. So because the coach was moving, he has to go from there. And he said, while going, he said that Mr. Pickwick should pay for the drinks. And he ran out of the room.
Thank you, children. Stay safe.